Furman Paladin basketball 1998-99 under the direction of head coach Larry Davis was a season filled with signs of promise for the future.
Paladins down by two here, 67-65 off to Bubba Smith. On the left corner it goes. There's a three-point shot. It's good! Julius knocks down a three. Furman leads by one. 10 seconds remaining. McCray into the forecourt and comes on the dribble. Gets it off left side. Brown for the game winner. It's off the rim, no good. Rebound, McShinson. And Big Mac's gonna dribble him out.
It was a season of ups and downs.
Well, all I know was I just remember falling, and then the next thing I remember was the hospital. So it was a real scary moment. But the Western Carolina game, when I came back, I was just so happy just to be back, because I was just thinking, looking at the tape, I was like, I couldn't have got up. What if I didn't get up from that fall or something like that? So I'm just thankful to God that he just enabled me to come back and play. I mean, even though I came back and did hurt my knee, I'm glad to be here and just glad to play again. That's all.
The 1998-99 Paladins won 11 regular season games, and everyone involved with the program is excited about the future.
Recruiting right now is great. Recruiting for a guy like Larry Davis is very easy, because he is a player's type of coach. He cares a lot about those players off the court as well as on the court. He's very concerned with how they do academically. And so it's very easy for me to go out and sell Larry Davis and sell the Furman basketball program. Furman, the university, has a lot to offer. The academics are, at very high level. And the arena certainly helps, to have this sort of facility in the Southern Conference give you an edge on some of the schools. Being the type of academic school that it is also gives you an edge. So the program is growing. The type of players that we've gotten in the program so far certainly helps, get the next, great player here at Furman.
Timmons Arena has two seasons in the books as the Paladins' new on-campus basketball facility, but it's the future that has fans of all ages dreaming of the return of championship basketball to Furman.
Lord, it's cold.
I know it's cold.
How about it's in Timmons Arena?
Yes. All right. Yeah, it looks like they have a bigger sign if they want to make a big deal out of it.
This is where the boys in shorts are.
Well, it's too cold for those boys to have on any kind of shorts tonight.
14-10. Deep in the left corner, it's Julius taking it to the hole. Double punch, got it. Kyle Julius, a freshman from Thunder Bay, Ontario. Up top it goes, McShinsey, ball fake, taking it to the hole, lays it in with the right hand. Marcus to Petrovic, who just came in. Steven Petrovic, quick look inside from Brown to Petro, and he jams it.
Love Shack.
That's my favorite.
We can do Love Shack.
Y'all know Love Shack?
Yeah, we can do Love Shack.
Well, all right. We're going to go ahead and play Love Shack for a little while.
Come on, here we go.
Yeah.
Love Shack, baby! Woo!
Cunningham holds high on the right side to go up top, stolen by Bubba Smith. Bubba taking it in from the right side, lays it up and in. The drought is over. Swing it around again. Dillegar gets in the paint, puts up the runner, partially blocked by Jeff Williams. Ball comes down. We can count the basket. And Daniel Quigley will get a three-point play opportunity. Bubba starts to drive, goes high post to Thomas, give and go. Dillegar takes it to the hole, lays it in over Brinson. Nice play by the Furman Paladins.
And see how wonderfully easy it is to serve yourself here at Timmons Arena. See, we just want your dining experience to be as pleasant as possible, so you can just get whatever you want and with whomever you want. Are y'all all right? Oh, Lord, I've injured the cheerleading team. Oh, Norma Jean, they're not going to let us stay in here. Norma Jean, somebody get the trainer. Somebody get the trainer.
Skip pass back to the left, and Anthony Thomas right back to Bubba on the right. They go up top with it now to Dillegar, right back to Bubba. He's going to bomb a three. Yes! Nothing but the bottom of the net. Julius on the left wing. Will bring it outside, working against Gable. Loses him. Top of the key. Jumper! Nailed it! Kyle Julius, the Thunder Bay Bomber from straightaway, ties this baby up 49-49. Trombley with a bomb from the right side. It's no good off the rim. That's part of that 19% John was talking about. Bubba Smith rebounds for Furman. He'll bring it into the forecourt. McShinson, quick look down low. Gilligard got the basket. He's on the foul. Marcus Gilligard. Brown on the left side. One dribble. Goes left block. McShinson whirls to his right. Puts it up and gets a roll.
Well, this is nice.
Well, it's awfully little.
They need a maid.
That's what they need. They have commemorative cubby holes.
They have cubby holes with their names. Oh, Lord. Oh, Louise, a big screen TV.
I don't even think that would fit in your double wide, would it?
Well, it is. I think it is a day long.
Oh, a double wide size TV.
Oh, you think we can watch Days of Our Lives?
We can try.
Largent in the backcourt. Green has the ball stolen away by Marcus Gilligard. He hooks it weak side. Bubba Smith lays it in with his offhand. There's a ball knocked away by Thomas and stolen. He stripped Rogers. Thomas headed the other way. Takes it to the hole. Lays it up and in. Anthony Thomas. Four straight points. Ravenel flashes to the post, but they go to Chadwick on the left side. He drives across the top of the key. Dishes in the corner, and Davis is open for a three. That won't go. Ball knocked outside. Julius comes up with it. Furman with a three-on-one break. He dishes to Foster, and Foster lays it in. Pulls up on the right point, driving across the top of the key, uses a McShinsa pick. Chadwick on him. Quickly back to the right, it goes to Gilligard. Now Julius deep in the right corner. Three-point shot is good.
Here, come on, Louise. Here we go. Hey, y'all.
Jean.
Hey,
honey,
look, boys in shorts.
Leave them alone, honey. They're practicing.
Good to see
you. Don't get all over these
boys. Come here.
Hey, how y'all doing? It's nice to see y'all.
All right, good.
I'm Mistress Louise Spiffy, and your name is?
I'm Bubba.
You're Bubba.
It's Bubba.
Is he related to you?
Yeah, hey, hon.
And what's your name, sweetheart?
Stas.
Stas. See if you can get him to say F-U all the time.
Stas, can you say F-U all the time for us?
F-U всегда.
Tell him that we're going to find a big enough car and we're going to take him to the drive-thru to get him whatever it was he said he liked. Okay?
All right, Stas, they said they're going to find a big enough car for you, and then they're going to take you to the drive-thru and get your food for you.
Yeah.
Спасибо огромное. Я вам очень благодарен.
Well, my
suit. That suits me, doesn't it?
I couldn't say that no better.
Yeah, well,
yeah,
let's go.
Yeah,
be careful.
Here.
Which way are we going?
Going this way.
Are we going this way?
Yeah.
Oh, well.
I got boys in shorts.
Well, y'all know
that. She's been looking for this guy.
You know, I'm going to need to write a thank you note to your mother. Who is your mother?
Furman head coach Larry Davis is one of the hardest working coaches in the business, and he intends on building his Paladins into consistent winners and championship contenders in the Southern Conference. Davis has the support of athletic administration.
Well, I'm excited about Coach Davis because I had the opportunity to hire him, and I take a great pride in that. That wasn't an easy task, believe me. It looks easy from the outside, but to find a coach that can fit into the Furman environment and have a quality program set in our academic situation is difficult to find to begin with. But what I really wanted was somebody who wouldn't set any kind of artificial ceiling, who really believed he could come here and have an outstanding Division I team. And Larry believes he can do that, and he's already demonstrated in the first 2 years that he can put up where he speaks up.